And now, the interim city manager, Amy Chan.
Thank you. On behalf of the city, I'd like to welcome you all to 2012 Quest Award celebration. So I want to do just a couple recognitions here. I'd like to have all those past Quest recipients stand up to be recognized. Thank you. Next, I'd like to recognize our VIP that are able to join us today. First, Nancy Newton and Bill Wilson from the Fremont Union High School District. Where's Nancy? Please stand up. Thank you. And from the Santa Clara Water District, our past mayor, Patrick Kwok. Thank you. I know we have some past council members and mayors here in the room, so please stand up to be recognized. I won't name names. So last but not least, our own council members, Mayor Santoro, Vice Mayor Mahoney, Councilmember Wong, Councilmember Chang, Councilmember Sings would have joined us today if he's not out of town playing with the Scouts. It really has been my honor to be able to join you today. This is a very, very special occasion, and I'm so totally impressed with how this community worked together to build a richer and much more vibrant community. And that's all because we have so many volunteers and organizations give so much back to Cupertino. And so we are today a much better place because the efforts that you all have given. So pat yourself on the back, because you have done it. And the Quest Award, as most of you know, started in 1996. And over this period of time, we have recognized over 125 organizations and individuals for their stepping out to make a difference. And so tonight, we have another chance to honor some of these outstanding contributions. I also recognize that there are still many unsung heroes. So for those unsung heroes, please, your friends need to recognize them next year. So without further ado, we want to get the program started. So I'm going to give you our mayor, Mark Santoro.
As you know, I'm into making long speeches, so I guess we'll start with the first recipient, which actually isn't an individual this year, but the Shinsu Sister City Association. Can we have the tape, please?
It would be difficult to estimate the number of board meetings Patrick Kwok has attended during the 3 decades he's lived in Cupertino. Let's just say his volunteer efforts on behalf of the city have taken place while seated in countless conference rooms on many different dioceses and in administrative offices throughout the state. Patrick believes in working from the inside out, promoting 3 objectives: quality of life, healthy kids, and cultural diversity. A former city council member and mayor, he has also served on the Cupertino Planning Commission and is an active member of the Cupertino Rotary, St. Joseph's Church, and the Cupertino YMCA Board of Directors. Last year, Patrick was co-chair of the YMCA's Triangle Campaign, which exceeded its fundraising goal. He also served on a special building task force for the Y. He also participated in a campaign effort with state elected officials in successfully naming the Cupertino Mary Avenue pedestrian bridge after the late Cupertino Mayor Don Burnett. And as a current board member of the Santa Clara Valley Water District, Patrick ensures that Cupertino is well represented beyond its city limits. He was instrumental in helping Cupertino receive grants for trails and stream restoration at McClellan Ranch Park and Blackberry Farm. His expertise in environmental engineering also has led him to seats on numerous state environmental boards. With commitment and know-how, Patrick works to achieve the best for Cupertino, from protecting the community's natural resources to championing its children.
Patrick, could you join us? Well, I said it was a group. Patrick's like a group. He really is. He kind of gets around. I have this sheet, and I've been instructed carefully to make sure I do things in this precise order so we don't roll the tapes out of order, but apparently my sheet's not quite in the right order. So now they want you to... For all the new next group of recipients, there's a little X on the floor or a plus, depending on where direction you're coming from, and that's so they can take your picture and the camera can pick you up, and so that if I say something you don't like, you can't get close enough to get near the mic. So Patrick, as most of you know, was a former council member and former mayor here in the city of Cupertino. Some of you may not know, he's the current chairman of the Santa Clara County Water Board. Patrick's also a civil engineer by training, so his engineering background's come in very handy in civil engineering with the Water Board. His wife, Susan, who was out there somewhere, I saw her, there she is also a registered nurse, by the way. They came here in 1967, I believe, from Hong Kong, where he's done marvelous things and got involved with the city, became a citizen of the United States, and has served in public office and done a wonderful job. I personally owe something to Patrick. For those of you that don't know, a few years back when I was running for office, somebody said some things that were untrue about me in the paper. And it, unbeknownst to me, Patrick with some other people got together and were kind enough to write a letter to the paper explaining that these things weren't true. And I greatly appreciate that. I want to thank him for that. So without further ado, I would like to present the 2012 Quest Award, first recipient, to Patrick Kwok. So I guess, should we read these once, or? There's several proclamations, and all the recipients are getting the same proclamations, and so I guess we'll do it once. The first one is from Mike Honda, Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition for Patrick Kwok and all the other recipients. The next one is a certificate of recognition presented to Patrick Kwok from Senator Joe Smidian. The third one is a certificate of commendation presented by County Supervisor Liz Niss. The fourth one is a certificate of recognition presented by Assemblyman Paul Fong. And the last one is a long, rather boring proclamation from the mayor of Cupertino, so I won't we won't go through this one, but all the winners will also get one, so I'm not going to read Patrick's, otherwise I have to read everyone's, or everyone read everyone's, but it's a proclamation for Patrick.
Good evening, everybody, and honorable mayors and the city council and city staff. It is my extreme honor this evening to receive the CREST Award. The award means a lot to me. And being the first one in the award, I'm going to be really brief because I'm going to allow following recipients to make the remarks. But I'd like to thank the people who nominate me, Michael Godwell and Honorable Christopher Lee, who nominated me for the award, and also the constituents in Cupertino whom I served, and the support from my family and who encouraged me, and most important, the City Council and the City of Cupertino who provides me an opportunity to serve. And it's a great honor. I really treasure this award, and it means a lot. Once again, thank you very much.
No, don't take my paper there.
Let's go back.
Yeah, you can. Thank you again. And once again, Patrick, I want to thank you for your courage in the past, which was act of courage, which is what we need from our residents and elected officials. Okay, I'm going to try this again. I think this time we're going to do the Shinsu Sister City. Can we roll the tape? Cross my fingers.
Last fall, 25 young students from halfway around the world traveled to Cupertino to stay with local families and learn a bit about Western culture. Their visit came about only after months of steady planning by the small committed group of people who make up the Cupertino Shinsu Sister City Association. Dedicated to the principle of mutual understanding and trust among different nations, members of the Sister City Association worked diligently to bring the Chinese students to Cupertino. They negotiated details with two different school boards and four separate schools. This successful event was just one item on the Sister City's 2011 agenda. A reverse exchange in which 15 Cupertino students stayed for a week with Shinsu families took place during the spring. And beyond these student trips, there were business representatives, city and school officials from both cities who traveled back and forth to meet on three separate occasions. For nearly 20 years, members of the Sister City Group have used such activities to strengthen ties between Cupertino and Shinsu. Their work is a bridge between two different worlds, where common ground is explored and ideas are shared. The group's volunteer efforts have helped the Cupertino community gain insights to such key areas as education, culture, urban administration, and business, insights that lead to both expanded opportunities and horizons.
Can we have the Shinsu Sister City representatives up here, please? So I have all these great little facts here about the Sister City. But I've been the Sister City liaison, as many of you know, for several years. This year it's Councilmember Gilbert Wong. But the Sister City reps, I must say, I count as my friends as well as colleagues. They've wonderful people. They've done a great job. It's just a wonderful trip people go on. I had the honor of going, as most of our council members have, to our Shinsu Sister City last year. It was a great trip and just a wonderful place to be and see. However, the council members going is nothing compared to the students that go. The student exchange program is phenomenal. The Sister City actually kind of got started about 18 years ago, and they've been doing the student exchange for, we can agree on eight. So after 3 years of being the liaison, I'm still not sure of the number. So but it's getting close to 10. And every time I see the students go, they're kind of nervous about going and stuff. And then when they come back, they're you know, sad to have left. And the students that come visit here are always in tears when they leave to go back home because they've made such close friends. So it's a wonderful program, and anyone who's thinking about it, I suggest that you apply. It's just a great trip to go on. They have wonderful events. The kids got to go to the glass blowing factory and shoot archery and stuff like that, and we had to go to meetings with dignitaries. But anyway, it was still a wonderful trip. So I'd like to now present the 2012 Crest Award to the Shinsu Sister City.
It's okay. Well, good evening, everyone, all the VIPs here, all the award recipients and contributors to the community. I want to thank you all and thank the City Council and thank all the support that we got from the school board and also the person, Vicky Tsai, who nominated us for this great award tonight. This award has to be shared by our small team. And our team is small but mighty at the same time. Our team of six is able to involve 100 families each year for the student exchange program. And I'd like to take a few minutes to introduce our team members. And to my right is Ralph Alto. Ralph is a great supporter in activities, and he's able to arrange NASA visit for all the visiting students every year. And he also served as a secretary in the past 2 years. And Janice Soon. Janice is our expert in Hsinchu connections, and she's not only very familiar with the social culture of Hsinchu, but also political culture of Hsinchu. She's the key person behind the scene to strengthen the connection between the Sister City Association and the Hsinchu City. So, and Janice is also our chairperson in the past 2 years in 2010 and 2009. And I'm the current chair, Angela, and I'm obviously the city council liaison for the association. My primary position is to contact city council and also the school board. The small team is able to bring 24 Hsinchu students to Cupertino students to Hsinchu this year. And on April 20th of 2012 this year, we were in Hsinchu attending the farewell party. And I look at 200 faces with big, big smiles. And these are faces of city officials, Janice and myself, and our 24 students, our two chaperones, teachers, and also all the families, the host families from Hsinchu. They're very happily attending this event. So I know at the moment that we reached our goal to bring the communities together. So today's award is not only a recognition, but also an encouragement to keep us going. And I think Janice has a few words to say.
It's an honor to be working with such passionate volunteers for the Cupertino Hsinchu Sister City Student Exchange Program. Without their hard work and the persistent efforts, we couldn't make the student exchange program so successful.
Okay, last man up. My name is Ralph Audi, and I'm happy to work with these fine ladies, but I do want to say a personal thing here. As a man, I'm always outnumbered by all these good ladies that are working in the program, and so if there's a couple of men that would enjoy working next year, come on in. Thank you.
Hey, don't leave yet. Don't leave yet. I wanted Ralph to get a little more camera time. He wore his fancy dress hat, so I'm also going to present these awards and proclamations to you. Okay, the third Crest Award recipient this evening is our Cease and Harvey Burnett. Can we have the tape, please?
Harvey and Celia Barnett believe in togetherness. They travel, ski, and cook together, and together every Wednesday they show up at West Valley Community Services to volunteer. This active, caring couple logged well over 1,000 hours of service last year, a tribute to their long-standing support for local residents in need. Both former educators with the Cupertino Union School District, the Barnetts make an impact throughout the entire WVCS operation. Harvey, a past president of the agency's board of directors, runs the Wednesday Food Pantry, which serves more than 2,000 clients every year. And Celia helps out with data entry, filing, assembling goodie bags for various programs, and assisting with the organization's many special events. Whether it's chaperoning a back-to-school shopping spree, checking in clients for the annual Adopt-a-Family program, or serving as WVCS ambassador, the Barnetts can always be counted on to lend a hand. Staff members say Celia completes every project with quiet efficiency and then lobbies them for more to do. With the same level of energy, Harvey expands his volunteer service to the Cupertino Rotary Club and the City of Cupertino's Housing Commission, where he sits as an advisory board member. Together, hour by hour, one Wednesday at a time, the Barnetts work to strengthen the community they love. Together, they share a commitment to help improve the lives of those around them.
Susan Harvey. So, yeah, no, it's better. She's closer to me. She's better looking, so. No, she's on the X. She's following directions. She's good. So, I guess I kind of know Harvey from, you know, he's been around for a while and worked on things on the commission, as you saw on the tape, and also West Valley. What I didn't know that I fake in my little cheat sheet here was he was principal of the Stevens Creek Elementary School at one time. And Cease has been also was involved with the Cupertino Union School District as well. So that was news to me. What I know them for is if you ever ask them what's going on, they're going to tell you about West Valley. So tonight I ask if there's anything in particular they'd like me to talk about that people might not know, and they go, well, we're most proud of West Valley. So I guess that's pretty much a consistent story with what they have to say. Very active in the community, very, very helpful people who work tirelessly helping others. And we actually have two little plaques. See, we want to make sure they're equal, because otherwise, if whoever's name would be first would be problematic.
Not knowing that I was supposed to say something, I hadn't planned anything. But I wish to thank the community for this wonderful award. Harvey and I have always wanted to give back to this community. It's a wonderful community, and we never feel that we have given enough. So thank you very much.
Come on, Harvey, you always have something to say. You want to say anything?
Well, as an ex-educator in the Cupertino School District, it was a pleasure to serve and help children and to help the district move forward in the area of technology. Excuse me. And when I retired, I had promised myself that I would volunteer and serve the community in a variety of ways. And then I have a friend of mine who had been very active on the West Valley Community Services Board, and he got me involved a lot in the going to the board and becoming a board member and then serving as a volunteer in the food pantry every week. So it's been a pleasure. I look forward to doing more, helping. We've been on the Housing Commission and several other city functions, just trying to help the community be a better place for all of us.
So once again, we have our awards and commendations. This time we have two of each, so one of you can get them all.
Okay, thank you, Mark.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay, we're done. Unless anybody else wants to.
One thing about the Crest Award recipients, I've noticed they never want to talk, and they're really eager to get off the stage. But So with that, I'd like to once again acknowledge that everyone are getting the same commendations and thank Mike Honda, Joe Smidian. I knew I was going to do this. Liz Niss and Paul Fong. Did I miss one? I got Liz. Oh, yeah, and the city of Cupertino for the, I knew there was one missing for the awards and proclamations. Our next speaker, I guess, or giver of awards is Vice Mayor Orrin Mahoney.
Thanks, Mark. This is one of the more fun things to do every year, and I'm we really have a small, close-knit group in the city that does a lot of the work. And all three of the people that I'm going to be presenting awards to tonight are not just great volunteers and contributors in the community, but they're also good friends. And they all three of them, as you'll find out, you know, have a way of having fun while we're doing good work. So I'd like to start with the first one being Bev Lenihan, and let's start with the tape, please.
Whether the work is paid or pro bono, Beverly Lenihan helps those who help others. A business consultant who specializes in fundraising for nonprofits, Bev has assisted her clients in raising nearly $60 million over the course of her career. Away from the job, she uses her formidable skills in strategic planning, marketing, and communications to strengthen local volunteer groups and create positive changes in the community. As president of the Cupertino Rotary Club last year, Bev worked tirelessly on programs to help the club manage its ongoing growth. Under her guidance, committee members developed some 32 playbooks. These are how-to manuals for various projects. Bev also shares her organizational talents with the Cupertino Library Foundation, where she successfully launched an advisory board and helped establish the Cupertino Poet Laureate Program. In addition, she was a key player in setting up the Plain Truth Health Information Center at the library and in introducing middle school students to a program that illustrates the joys of scientific research through the library's online database. On the job and in the community, Bev fills her life with service to others. With vision and leadership, she inspires others to help wherever there's a need.
Up to the X here.
Thank you so much.
So actually, Bev and I share a lot of common background. Both of us came from the high-tech field, and both of us spent a lot of time in the marketing communications portion of that. So we share a lot of common background and oftentimes think about things the same way. We don't always think about things the same way. But that's good, and when we don't, it's very easy to just sit down with Bev and talk things through as you need to do in a lot of projects and a lot of things. So usually I'm the one that's recruiting people to do new ventures, but the tables turned this year when Bev was a founding board member of the Faith in Action Silicon Valley Rotating Shelter Program that just got reestablished as a separate organization. And all of a sudden Bev said, oh, how'd you like to join the board there? And I'm on the board working with Bev and again doing great things as she always does for the community. So I thank you for all the work you do, and I thank you for your friendship as well. And here, I guess I give you the award first.
Thank you so much. Orrin, thank you so much. It is fun to stand here with a friend and a colleague, and also to stand before all of you. So many of you are our community fiber that makes Cupertino strong, and I am very humbled and blessed to be a part of Cupertino. When I came here in 2007, I knew no one in Cupertino except my husband-to-be, and got the opportunity to join Rotary, and to become a part of that community, and from there to find other ways to be of service. And I have to say, there are no end to the opportunity to be of service in Cupertino, but I've been very fortunate to work with the Library Foundation. I'd like to thank Eno Schmidt for his contribution to my nomination this evening, Marge Mancuso from our Rotary Club, who's been my right-hand person for a couple of years, and then also Bob Adams, who I get to be with Rotary and with the Cupertino Library Foundation. So we continue to have a lot of fun together, do good stuff, and I think we can continue to do so along with all the work that you do. I'd also like to thank my husband, Phil. He's been instrumental in keeping me keeping me level and sound, and reminding me that fun does go along with all of this work. So thank you. I will continue to be of service, and it's a joy to do that here in Cupertino. Thanks so very much.
Okay, my second recipient tonight that brings fun to everything that she does is Dolly Sandoval. So why don't we roll that tape?
What makes Dolly Sandoval run? It's not the course she loves, it's the cause. The self-proclaimed non-runner laces up her shoes every year and shows up at the starting lines for the YMCA's Bridge Run and the city's Big Bunny Fun Run. Why? Because both races raise money for citywide recreational activities. And for Dolly, that's a compelling reason to run. A longtime public official and community volunteer, she is a familiar figure at nearly every function and fundraiser in Cupertino. While serving two terms on the Cupertino City Council, she was a strong advocate for economic development, education, environmental protection, and housing. In 2011, she worked with a nonprofit group, Senior Housing Solutions, and with city staff, contractors, and other housing agencies to open the Price Avenue House, a community home for five seniors. And as an advisory board member for West Valley Community Services, Dolly took a lead role in the organization's first Taste of Compassion event, benefiting hunger and homeless services through a partnership with local restaurants. Whether she's speaking at a meeting of the League of Women Voters, at a leaders in training session, or in a college or high school classroom, Dolly never misses a chance to deliver her message. There's value in civic engagement. Get involved.
So as you see, you know, I've known Dolly for quite a while, obviously quite a few years on the council. And one of the great things about Dolly is that she has stayed involved, very much involved. Recently, we had an issue where we needed some help working through some redevelopment agency oversight issues, and we needed some connectivity into some of the other organizations, and Dolly right away volunteered to do that, and we had a very good outcome definitely as part of that. So Dolly and I first got to know each other on a raft trip. Dolly leads raft trips. I don't know how many people know that. And so one of the fundraising events, I bid on this raft trip back in 2001. And Dolly led the raft trip, and we were there. And I was thinking of running for council, and she was thinking of running for council. And it was like, are you going to run? Yeah, I don't know. Are you going to run or whatever? So we ended up both running, and she beat the pants off me. So. So it was great, and gotten to know her even better since. So Dolly, here are all your certificates, but more important.
So I think I have to tell the other side of that story, which totally blows my whole thing tonight, but I'll make it work in the end, I hope. I was the guide on that raft trip, and Orin and his family were enjoying the South Fork American River, and we were talking about who's going to run and how serious we both were about running. And Orin said, well, gosh, if I fall in, you know, I can make a campaign brochure that says Dolly Sandoval doesn't play fair, she pushed me in the river. And I said, oh, no, Oren, I have this dialed. I already know. If you fall in, I'm saving your ass, your rear. Your bleep. And the campaign brochure is going to say, even if she's running against him, she's going to help him along the way. So we have been friends ever since then, and I appreciate that, Oren. Not exactly the story I was going to say tonight, but on that note, I think there's probably nothing more I can say except no matter what it is you do in life, find your passion and really work hard. Last night, if you're a Giants fan, last night you know there was a perfect game pitched. Matt Cain has some amazing talents. But what's nice about this community is you don't have to have those exact talents to give back in this community. What each and every one of you has is a smile you can lend to a cause, a helping hand, a family that's in need you can give food or shelter to, help somebody read. All of us in this room should be getting a CREST Award sometime in our lives because all of us should take extra steps to make sure this community is in good hands. Thank you.
Gonna be hard to top that. Okay. But I think we can do it. Because our next awardee is Judy Wilson. So why don't we start with the tape?
When Judy Wilson signed up as a participant in the City of Cupertino's Leadership 95014 program last year, those who knew her wondered why she wasn't teaching the course. There's no doubt at all that Judy is a born leader, and she's been demonstrating that quality ever since she moved to the area more than 25 years ago. Last year's volunteer work offers just a glimpse of how she operates. She served on the Fremont Union High School Foundation Board and is now vice president. She chaired the annual crab feed, which raised $60,000 for the foundation. She also sat on the board of the Cupertino Fremont Sunnyvale Council of PTAs, and she took on major responsibilities as a Cupertino Rotary Club member. As one of the Rotary's Red Badge mentors, Judy shepherds new members through the process of getting involved in the club's many activities. She's also the Rotary's volunteer coordinator for its fall festival, and she chairs the speech contest for local high school students. Last year, she also chaired the club's teacher mini-grant program. This human dynamo is a legend in the Cupertino School District. As a 15-year parent volunteer at Lincoln, Kennedy, and Monta Vista schools, she earned honorary service awards three times, as well as the Golden Oak Service Award, California's most prestigious PTA honor. A seasoned volunteer and community organizer, Judy is well known for her caring attitude, boundless energy, and ever-present optimism. And if you're ever looking for her, she'll be at the front of the line, leading the way.
So Judy's great. If you notice, almost every one of the Rotary things in there, I was in the same picture, and that's because, you know, whatever I needed help with, whether it be with Fall Festival last year and the staffing, which is a humongous job, or whether it this year on the membership committee doing all the Red Badge stuff and just anything else. So Judy is in her little notes here, which I already knew, one of the things is Judy, like me, can't say no. You know, it's like I'm kind of like, no, you don't have to raise your hand there. And she always does it with a smile, so that's great. And really appreciate working with Judy. And the only thing is a couple of years from now, I want to see her on the other side of the podium here. So.
Okay, I had a great speech plan too, but I have to follow Dolly. That's tough. Anyway, so all those things up there that you saw me doing, they don't happen in a vacuum. And To quote Hillary Clinton, as many people do, it takes a village of people to support you and to have talents and to have a community of people who, you know, believe in community volunteerism. And well, thank you doesn't even begin to express the gratitude I have towards this community, my family, my friends who support me at everything I do. So I'm going to take my minute of fame to thank basically my heroes. So I'd like to thank my family and especially my husband, Bill Wilson, who just supports me in everything I do. And basically then also volunteers for everything I do. So you get two of us. So thank you, Bill. And I'd like to thank my children who have allowed me to volunteer in their schools and been a part of their world and volunteered for their baseball. And how lucky is that, really? So, and lastly, I know my friends get so tired of this, but I could not do any of this without the cadre of the most talented friends in the world, some of whom are sitting here tonight. Thank you for coming. And some who couldn't make it. I think we're on TV, so I'm going to say thank you to all of those people out there who couldn't make it tonight. And then a word about our city. What a great place to live, and what an outstanding city we live in. And I feel very lucky to have just landed in Cupertino and have the opportunity to make this my home. So thank you for all of you that have taken my journey. And then one more quick thank you to Robert and Ray. My friends know this, but you didn't, but I've always wanted to be in a movie. And now I am. So thank you, Robert and Ray. Thank you.
Okay, and with that, I'll bring our next presenter up. That'd be our council member, Gilbert Wong.
Good evening. It's an honor to be here as a council member to join with our city manager, city council, and the community for this wonderful night. And first, I would like to announce the recipient, and that is Helene Davis. Can we roll the tape, please?
Some people talk and some people take action. Helene Davis belongs to the latter group. She's definitely a doer. Raised in Cupertino, Helene has stayed close to her roots, bringing up her own family here and becoming a perpetual community volunteer. Last year, as chair of the programs committee, Helene was deeply involved in Rotary Club activities. In addition, her longtime affiliation with the Cupertino Historical Society led her to join a committee that created the new Santa Clara Valley History Collaborative. The Collaborative is a partnership among three local organizations, the Historical Society, the Cupertino Library Foundation, and the Cupertino Library. Together, these groups offer windows to local history through rotating exhibits in the library. Helene is passionate about preserving the history of our city and has spent 9 years on the board of the Cupertino Historical Society, 4 of those years as president. Her strong commitment to the past was a key reason why the city of Cupertino appointed her to a seat on the Ad Hoc Historical Preservation Committee. Education is another of Helene's community interests, and since her eldest child was in elementary school, she has volunteered on PTA boards at every level. This includes service on the Cupertino-Fremont-Sunnyvale Council of PTAs, made up of 19 PTA groups in the Cupertino Union School District. Helene demonstrates her devotion and loyalty to the city she loves every day of the year.
I was enjoying that so much, I almost forgot to come here. I also got to personally know Helene as well very well. And with any great organization, maybe the Rotary Club, but especially the Cupertino Historical Society, you always have a strong volunteer. And Helene has always been very strong with the Cupertino Historical Society. She has been a native of Cupertino that went through elementary, middle, and high school here in Cupertino. And also her children has been going to school here as well, too. And as you can see in the tape, that she's an active volunteer. Maybe the Rotary Club, at the school, and especially at the Cupertino Historical Society, because to better know the community better, you have to know the history. Congratulations, Helene Davis.
Well, it's such an honor to receive this award. Thank you to the city and to the staff and to Ray and his crew who just did a fabulous job of the video, and also to the folks that took the time to nominate me. I really appreciate that. And I also wanted to acknowledge all the wonderful people that I volunteer with in this community, especially those with the Cupertino Historical Society and with the Rotary Club of Cupertino. I couldn't do it without you. And what I really love about Cupertino is that we all support one another in our endeavors. We collaborate with each other. And I am just honored to be with a fabulous group that is also winning this Crest Award tonight. But lastly, I'd like to thank my family, my two lovely daughters, Leah and Julie, but especially my husband, Jim, who supports me in all of the endeavors that I take on. So thank you very much. I'm very honored to get this award.
Thank you, Debbie.
Let's give a warm applause to Helene Davis. So I'm very lucky tonight to introduce one of two great women, and the other woman that I'd like to introduce is Lin Ching. Can you roll the tape, please?
Every year, plenty of very diverse and notable special events take place in Cupertino, but most of them have at least one thing in common, Lin Ching's fingerprints. For the 20 years she's lived here, Lin has been a volunteer dynamo, remarkably active in several organizations while raising two sons and running a business. Last year, her efforts centered on Cupertino Rotary and Chamber of Commerce activities. She has had a hand in the Rotary's annual golf tournament, crab feeds, Eastern Elegance, Kids Shopping Day, Youth Leadership Awards Program, Kids Fishing Day, Operation Snowflake, and Student Speech Contest. For the Chamber, she conceived and chaired the Taste of Cupertino, held in the spring and fall. She also worked on the Diwali Festival of Lights, Star Awards, and Lunar New Year Luncheon. In addition, Lin is a member of the Cupertino Historical Society and an avid fundraiser for the American Cancer Society. She participated in the 2011 Relay for Life, has marched in the Avon Breast Cancer Walk, and is volunteering for this year's LunaFest Film Festival in Cupertino, benefiting cancer research. Lin steps up to assume leadership roles within each group she belongs to, and other members have recognized her incredible dedication with their most prestigious awards. This tireless mother and business owner volunteers with her whole heart, imprinting every hour of community service with her trademark generosity and energy.
Another great woman that I know personally very well, Lin Ching, and I worked very closely together in the Cupertino Chamber of Commerce, a native Californian with two kids, and it's really hard to raise two kids, work as a CPA. She recently has a new business called a Sustainable Living Group, and volunteer, and I just don't know how Lin does it. Chamber has many challenges, and with her background as finance, she dabbles a little bit in bookkeeping, became our president, sits on the executive board, and I just don't know how she does it. And it's my honor to give this award to my friend, Lin Ching.
Wow, watching these films has been great, seeing all these people. And you, if you noticed all the films that we're doing, you see a lot of the same people, so that's a great thing. I get to go further back down, but I just wanted to say that I echo the sentiments of so many of the past, the recipients tonight, is that I think I've been volunteering 10 or 12 years now, and I love doing it. I love giving back, and if you know me, you know I always like to have fun. So that's been part of my motto over the years, and that's why I think I've been doing it for so long.
And I just wanted to thank, I love living in Cupertino, and I wanted to thank the council and the city. And the best thing that's come out of all this is I've met some of my best friends through volunteering, and that, I think, says it all. So many of you guys are sitting in the audience, so thank you for supporting me, and I think we all support each other. I know Judy was, I think it was the crab feed. She was short on people, and she calls upon Joanne and I, and here we are. So I wanted to thank my kids who are here. A lot of them used to see them when they were much younger, but now they're all grown up back there. Kyle now is at San Francisco State first year and got good grades, thank God, so I'm very happy. Thank you. And then I have, my youngest one is at Monta Vista, and he just completed his first year with, I hope, good grades. We'll see about that. And then they put up with me all these years doing a lot of takeouts while I volunteer, and Joanne Manch probably would say that's a good thing because people that know me is I don't cook, so that's probably a good thing. But anyway, I just wanted to thank you. It's been an honor volunteering, and thank you so much for awarding me this award. Thank you.
Maybe she went to Catholic to get her beauty.
Again, it was my honor. Two great women helping the community tonight, and I'm really appreciative of that. It's now my honor to introduce the next presenter, and that's Councilmember Barry Chang. Thank you.
Oren, you mentioned you're going to ask Judy to run a couple years from now, right? Yep. I did ask her to run through a common friend. The answer come back is too many men in the city council. So she's not running. Okay. Not last time. Okay. I want to say all the awardees is really very kind heart. Like Judy and Helene walk almost every day to my around my house, helping taking care of my dog. If you know my dog is, has a character like me. Okay. and then Harvey was the first one last Wednesday to tell me I feel sorry about your loss on the election, and I told the Rotary Club leader, I say, oh, don't feel sorry for me. I deserve it. Okay. I just ran out of time to win it, that's it. So my time is to give the award to two awardees. One is Kiwanis Club. Do you know the memorial park, that flagpole is donated by the Kiwanis Club? And then they've been doing the fundraising for 28 years for the senior at the senior center for 28 consecutive years. And they're volunteer, after most of them were retiree, get involved for 25 years. That's a long time, my goodness, right? So let's roll the prayer.
With brotherhood from sea to shine.
In the case of the Cupertino Kiwanis Club, size really doesn't matter. Not when a small group can make such a big difference. A true service organization, the Kiwanis Club has been supporting the Cupertino community since 1955. During those many years, members have dedicated countless hours of volunteerism to all segments of the population, from local students to senior citizens. Last year, for the 28th time in its long history, the club took charge of the annual appreciation luncheon for the volunteers at the Cupertino Senior Center. This effort involved everything from purchasing all the food to serving the meal and cleaning up afterward. The much-anticipated luncheon allows Senior Center staff members to honor nearly 200 volunteers. The luncheon carries a different theme every year, and willing club members always come up with a theme-appropriate menu. The club also makes it an intergenerational event, bringing in high school key club members to help. Among its many services, the Kiwanis Club sponsors scholarships for local key clubs, as well as youth activities from Boy Scouts to children's camps. For more than 30 years, the Cupertino Club has joined neighboring Kiwanians in producing the Special Games, an event bringing together about 900 severely disabled youth from 50 local schools for a day of fun competitive games at De Anza College. Working within the confines of its small membership, the Cupertino Kiwanis Club ably maintains its mission of service, giving, caring, and supporting without fuss or fanfare.
Those you may not know, Kiwanis Club also helping the historic Cupertino Historical Society and Salvation Army and American Red Cross and YMCA. Coming up. Thank you. So we have a lot of proclamation also. I'll do a reverse in reverse order, if you don't mind. First one is from our mayor, Mark Santoro. And the city council. I was instructed to say that. Okay, thank you. Next one will be from our supervisor, Lisnes. And then coming up to state, from State Assembly, Paul Fang. And then the next one is from State Senator Joe Smithian. I just had a good run with him just a couple of days ago. The last one is from Mike Honda.
Thank you.
Sure, come on up.
All right. Well, I didn't know I was going to be speaking tonight, but on behalf of the Cupertino Kiwanis Club, I want to thank you. My name is Dave Gragnola. As you heard, we have been in the community. We were formed in 1955, and everybody on the stage here, even though with just part of the club is here, has been a member at least 10 years. Fenton over there has been a member for 49 years. So we've done a lot of great things for the community since 1955. I want to thank Linda at the Cupertino Senior Center for nominating us. As you heard, we do prepare and cook a steak and chicken lunch for 150 seniors that are honored for their service to the Cupertino Senior Center. So even though we're not a big club, we still have a lot in the community that we do for for the folks here, and we're very honored and pleased to receive this award. So thank you very much.
Any one of the members want to say a few words? You're more than welcome. Yes. Not unlike me, right? Sorry. Okay, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Do you need certificates?
Next one is my favorite, Don Stubb. I remember one time I was working on the knee-high issue, walking in the neighborhood, and they pulled me into their house. And then I learned a lot from him. He actually has been working on the knee-high issue for over 30 years. And some of the neighbors told me, before you see a lot of dust in your closet. Now, less dust, because of all Don's and quite many of volunteers helping it. And I'm just the follower. Okay, so let's roll the tape.
West Valley Community Services is always humming with activity, but Monday mornings are especially hectic. That's when gleaners go out and collect a weekend's worth of produce and bread, dropping large loads off at the agency's food pantry. In those early morning hours, the food must be unloaded, sorted, and stocked all before the pantry opens to WVCS clients. That's where Don Staub comes in. In fact, he comes in every Monday morning to ensure that food from local grocers is efficiently transferred to the pantry shelves. And always when the doors open, both he and the pantry are ready to greet and assist visitors. Over the past 5 years, Don logged more than 500 volunteer hours for WVCS. In addition to his work in the food pantry, he trained and supervised other volunteers, helped organize fundraisers, and took on extra shifts whenever needed. Besides that, he is a member of the agency's board of directors and has served on committees from fund development to strategic planning. It's safe to say that Don knows the workings of WVCS inside and out. Passionate about its objectives and committed to serving clients with respect and dignity, he is a self-styled ambassador to the agency. Out in the community, he spreads the word about WVCS and never misses an opportunity to recruit new volunteers and donors. Don lives the mission of WVCS, stepping up and giving freely, using hard work, gentle humor, and abiding generosity to improve lives. His is an ongoing effort, beginning every Monday morning.
Don, coming up, Don can serve on the West Valley Community Service as the president of the board and the assistant in the food pantry. There's a Chinese saying, if you're in a small school, you could be a principal and the janitor at the same time. So Don is that good. You know, he can be doing a small job, doing it very well, or doing a big job and doing it very well too. Don, thank you very much. Coming up.
I'm honored to receive this award, and I'd like to thank West Valley Community Services for submitting my name for consideration, and of course, Cupertino City Council for accepting it. I'd like to thank all of the people involved at West Valley with the pantry. That includes the staff themselves for the organization, the gleaners that you saw delivering the food, and of course the merchants for the donations. That's key, obviously. And we have more merchants donating now than we have had in the past. And that's another tribute to WVCS staff. Most of you here know about WVCS and what we do and why and how we do it. But I often get asked by people that have lived in the area for quite a while what it is WVCS is, or WSVC, or what do you guys do? And I'd like to make an offer that if you belong to an organization that does want to do volunteer work, or you do want to do volunteer work yourselves, we're there. We're at the other side of Stevens Creek on Vista, right by the firehouse. You can visit us there, or you can go online, get some names and call people, or you can grab a hold of me outside and I'll give you a phone number and a name. Might even be mine. So the website is very complete. It has the current activities, past activities, and all the contacts in the organization and the mission statements and all those things that are interesting. So again, I'd like to thank everyone for this. And I guess I need to thank my wife and my son over there. My wife has been patient with some of these not necessarily with the day-to-day things at WVCS, but when there is a fundraising event, it's heavy duty. And some of you know that, and some of you know it takes a lot of hours and a lot of griping, but it gets done. So thank you again, and I'll keep it up.
Thank you. Good time. Good afternoon. Can you stay right there, then I'll give you all the proclamation. Okay. Then we'll take a picture. Okay.
So this is Crescent Wall. This one is from the mayor, Mark Santoro. Supervisor Justinus. This one from the assembly member. And then this one is from Senator Joseph Median.
Oh, okay. Great.
My good friend. And this one is from my Honda.
Thank you.
Then we take a picture and then we'll tell it, right?
So next one, I'm supposed to ask the mayor to come back up. Thank you.
So I want to thank you all for coming. I don't know about the rest of you. I've learned a lot of things tonight. Next time, Barry, I'll see why I read them all, the proclamations in the beginning, so the council members didn't have to. But and I also want to point out something really important about the all the winners tonight. They all figured out where the little X was on the floor and where to stand, so they're good at following directions, unlike some of us. So, couple misconceptions people have. My fellow council members and myself would love to take credit for everything that's happened, but to be honest, I should explain to you how Crest Award winners become Crest Award winners. They're nominated by a member of the community. Anybody in this room or any member of the community is free to nominate someone they think should be a Crest Award winner. And then the chairs of all the commissions actually vote on who the Crest Award winners are going to be. So the council, we have no place in the vote. Actually, we don't. Rick and his crew set up all the camera and the wonderful slides, so we don't do that. And I guess we get up here and try to talk and be entertaining, and so sometimes we don't do that either. But anyway, I want to point out that one thing that always humbles me here every year is I feel like I just, you know, I'm just pale by comparison to what I do for the community when I watch the Crest Award winners. It just makes me feel very honored to live in such a wonderful community here in Cupertino. It's just a stellar group of people that just do a wonderful job, and I want to thank them very much for all they've done for the community, and I think we should once again give them a big hand.